So the next speaker is Arantxa Ruiz Martinez, and the title is Standard Model Measurements by ATLAS and CMS. Please, 30 minutes.
Hello, I hope you can hear me.
Yeah, we hear.
Okay,
very
so
well, very well.
Yeah. I'm sharing now the slides, so I will start. It is a pleasure for me to present an overview of the standard model measurements performed by the ATLAS and CMS experiments. Just as a brief introduction, as we can see in the summary plots on the right-hand side, the production cross-section measurements performed by ATLAS on the top and CMS on the bottom. As you can see, we have many new RAN2 measurements. And in this talk, I will just cover really the most recent ones that I have highlighted and listed here. Okay, first, I will present the measurement of the transverse energy-energy correlations and the extraction of the strong coupling constant. As you know, the even shape observables are used to perform precise tests of perturbative QCD calculations and to extract the value of the strong coupling constant. In particular, for Hadron Collider experiments, we consider two observables, the transverse energy-energy correlations, which are defined in this formula, and their associated azimuthal asymmetry is also defined here. In the equations, the I and J indexes run over all the jets in a given event. The transverse energy is defined as the sum of the transverse energies of all the jets, and then phi is defined as the angle between the jets in the transverse plane. We can see in the plots on the bottom of the page the distribution of these observables, the transverse energy-energy correlations on the left-hand side and the asymmetry on the right-hand side as a function of the cosine of phi. These distributions are obtained for a value of HT2, which is defined as the scalar PT sum of the two leading jets in the event above 1 TeV. Then the measured data are compared to the predictions by different generators such as Pythia, Sherpa, and Herwig. The data are divided in 10 bins in HT2 in order to study the scale dependence of these observables. We can see in the plots on the top the systematic uncertainties for the transverse energy-energy correlations on the left-hand side and the asymmetry on the right-hand side, and we can see that the dominant uncertainty here is coming from the jet energy scale. Then the strong coupling constant is determined from fits to these two functions. We can see on the bottom of the page the running of alpha S, where different measurements performed by the LAC and Tevatron experiments are shown. And we can see in the tail at large values of Q, the 10 points with this measurement performed at 13 TeV. Okay, now moving to the measurement of the diphoton production cross-section, the main challenge in this analysis is to have a proper estimation of the background coming from non-prompt photons in jet events. We can see here the Feynman diagrams of our signal for direct photons, single and double fragmentation photons, and on the right-hand side for non-prompt photons from hadron decays, which is our dominant background. In this paper, the inclusive cross-section measurement has been obtained, as we can see in the plot on the left-hand side in the vertical line. And this is compared to the most accurate predictions that are available. This is compared to the Monte Carlo multi-leg generator, Sherpa, and also to the fixed order calculations provided by NNLOJET and by DIFOX. We can see that the best agreement is achieved for the multi-leg generator, Sherpa, and for the most accurate calculations at next to leading order provided by NNLOJET. In this measurement, we have also performed differential cross-section measurements as a function of different relevant observables, such as the transverse energy of the leading and subleading photons, the diphoton invariant mass, and the diphoton transverse momentum. Here we can see the measured data compared to the predictions by the multileg Sherpa generator and from the fixed order calculations provided by NNLOJET and IFOX. And as we have seen in the inclusive cross-section or fiducial cross-section measurement, the best agreement is achieved for the multileg Sherpa generator and the NNLOJET calculations. If we compare now the measured data with the fixed order calculations provided by NNLOJET at leading order, at next to leading order, and at next to leading order, we see that a very good agreement can be achieved with the calculations at next to leading order. And this illustrates the need to include higher order corrections in our calculations to properly describe the distributions from data. Okay, now moving to the collinear set boson emission. Here, a measurement of the set boson angular distributions in events where there is a set boson emitted collinear to a high PT jet is performed. We can see here the differential cross-section measurements as a function of delta R separation between the set boson and the closest jet for two different regions on the left-hand side, requiring the leading jet PT to be above 300 GeV, and on the right-hand side, requiring that the leading jet PT is above 500 GeV, which is a more extreme phase space and where we have less statistics. We can see that in these plots, there are two, we can distinguish two differentiate regions, the collinear region with, where the set boson is emitted close to the high PT jet, which is the region with low delta R values, and the back-to-back region between the set boson recoiling against a hadronic jet, which is the region around pi. Then the measured data is compared to the predictions given by MADGRAPH plus PCI-8 with up to two partons at next to leading order or up to four partons at leading order. And we can see that in the ratio, the best agreement is achieved in the case of up to two partons at next to leading order, although there is the agreement is within uncertainties, but there is some disagreement at very low values of delta R. Okay, now moving to the test of the lepton flavor universality. Here I present a measurement of the ratio of the branching ratio of the W boson decaying to tau nu over the branching ratio of the W boson decaying to mu nu. This is to probe the universality of the W coupling to charged leptons. For this measurement, we use the leptonic TT bar events as a probe of, as a sample of probe W bosons. Here, we tag the events that contain an electron or a muon decaying from a W, and then we probe muons that are prompt muons from the W decay or muons from the W decay with an intermediate tau lepton. We can see in the plot on the right hand side on the top the D0 distribution for prompt muons from the W decay in light green and for muons with an intermediate tau lepton that is the dark green. As we can see in the plot on the bottom right corner, the measure ratio is in very good agreement with the standard model expectation of one. This measurement was motivated by the flavor anomalies that have been seen at the LCB for some time, and also motivated by the long-standing deviation from LEP of 2.7 sigma that is seen also is shown in the plot on the right bottom corner. Just to remark that this measurement provides a factor two imprecision compared to LEP and has the best precision achieved up to now. Okay, now moving to the first LEC search of the rare exclusive hadronic decay of the the W boson going to a pion and a photon. Here the final state consists of an isolated photon plus an isolated track compatible with a pion. And in this analysis, a dedicated variable has been developed, which is the pion isolation variable that can be seen in the plot on the left-hand side, where we see the discrimination power between the signal and all the backgrounds. Here we select TTVAR events where AW decays leptonically, and then the signal is discriminated, developing a boosted decision tree. In this boosted decision tree, BDT, we use as input variables for the training, observables such as the lepton PT, the missing transverse energy of this pion isolation variable. You can see the BDT score in the case of the electron channel in the middle, and then the invariant mass distribution of the reconstructed pion and photon is fitted. Upper limits are extracted from this fit, and the limits are of the order of 10 to the minus 5, while the theoretical calculations are in the range between 10 to the minus 9 and 10 to the minus 6. Okay, now moving to photon-induced processes, we have the observation of the photon-induced W boson pair production. This is a test of the electroweak sector of the standard model, and we have direct access to the triple and quartic interactions, as we can see here in the Feynman diagrams. In this analysis, the protons radiate ISR photons and then stay intact or dissociate, as we can see in the diagrams with the corresponding percentages. Just to remark that we already had a RAN 1 evidence from both experiments, ATLAS and CMS, and this RAN 1 evidence has turned into observation now analyzing the RAN 2 dataset. So let me show you a nice event display. This is a candidate event of the photon-induced process of the W boson pair production, where the W's decay leptonically, one to a muon neutrino and the other to electron neutrino. This corresponds to an event recorded in the proton-proton collisions at QUIRE in 2018. You can see in the event display the vertex that has been reconstructed, where there is the muon track in red and the electron track in yellow, and no more tracks from this vertex. Okay, so we can see in this table the observed events in data of the photon-induced W boson pair production and the different backgrounds, where you can see that the dominant background is coming from the quark-induced W boson pair production. In this analysis, the set position of the interaction vertex is obtained according to this equation. And then the number of tracks, which is used to separate the signal from the backgrounds, is defined as the number of tracks in a window in the set axis within 1 millimeter around the set position of the interaction vertex. And these are the number of tracks, excluding the tracks from that are used to reconstruct the two leptons. And we can see in the plots on the bottom the transverse momentum of the electron and muon system, where we require to be above 30 GeV, where the signal is enhanced, and this observable, the number of reconstructed tracks, which for the signal region, as we see in the table, we require that the number of tracks is equal to zero. And then the other beams are used as control regions. Here we achieve an observation of 8.4 sigma. We had also the observation of the photon-induced dielectron production. In this case, we use the 2017 data set, with the ATLAS forward proton AFP detector inserted. This corresponds to a total integrated luminosity of 15 inverse MTOPA. In this case, the observation is with a significance of 9.7 sigma for the electron channel and 13 sigma for the muon channel. And just to remark that this is the first cross-section measurement using proton tagging at the LEC. We can see on the right-hand side the experimental setup with the ATLAS detector and the AFP detectors at both sides, side A and side C. And in this analysis, we define the fractional proton energy loss of the scattered proton and the fractional proton energy loss from the lepton kinematics. In the plots on the right-hand side, we can see the difference between these two variables where the signal peaks at zero. We can see the comparison of the events observed in the data and the predicted yields from signal and the combinatorial backgrounds. This is obtained in both sides, A and C. Okay, now moving to the electroweak production of a set boson plus two jets, we have here measured the differential cross-sections. This is sensitive to the vector boson fusion production mechanism. We can see on the bottom the typical diagrams corresponding to the electroweak set plus jets signal and the QCD production on the top, on the bottom. Here, I would like to highlight that the measured data are sufficiently precise to be able to distinguish between the different state-of-the-art theoretical predictions that have been computed with Pauhi plus Pithia, Herwig plus BBF NLO, and Sherpa version 2.2. In slide number 16, just to show the typical event selection criteria for this BBF topologies, where we require that the high diegetic invariant mass to be above 1 TeV, as we can see in the plot on the bottom right corner. We see that the electroweak signal is enhanced in the diegetic invariant mass tail, and also an important cut is the that the diegetic rapidity separation is above 2. Then we define an observable, which is the set centrality, which is used to define the signal region together with the number of jets in the gap. In this way, we have the signal region where the number of jets in the gap is equal to 0 and the set centrality is smaller than 0.5. The other cuts are used to define control regions. So in this paper, we have measured the differential cross-sections as a function of four observables, the diegetic invariant mass, diegetic rapidity separation, the dilepton PT, and the diegetic azimuthal separation. We can see in the plot on the left-hand side the differential cross-section as a function of the diegetic invariant mass for the inclusive set plus jets production, which is compared to the predictions provided by Sherpa and Matgraf plus PCI8, where there is some overestimation of the distribution by Sherpa in the tail. We can see on the right-hand side the differential cross-section as a function also of the diegetic invariant mass, but this case for the extracted electroweak signal. And here the measured data is compared to the generators Sherpa and Herwig plus BBF NLO and also Pauhek plus PCI8, where we see some overestimation also from Pauhek and Herwig. And then on the plots on the bottom, we can see the fractional uncertainties, which in the case of the inclusive production, the dominant is coming from the jet uncertainties, while in the electroweak signal, together with the jet uncertainties, we have large uncertainties coming from the strong set plus jets modeling. Okay, now moving to the electroweak production of a W and Z boson in association with jets, and the same sign W boson per production in association with jets. Here the vector boson scattering is contributing to the electroweak induced production, as we can see in the diagrams on the top, and we can see also the Feynman diagrams corresponding to the QCD production. Here we have achieved also an observation of the WSEC electroweak production at 6.8 sigma significance, and the differential cross-sections have been obtained as a function of different observables. Constrained on anomalous quartic cage couplings have been obtained in the effective field theory framework. So let me show you here the normalized differential cross-sections as a function of the diet invariant mass, on the left for the same sign W boson per production, and on the right hand side for the W set production, which is compared to math graph plus PCA 8. And on the bottom, we can see the observed events in data compared to the predicted yields from the different processes. And here we can see also some signals for anomalous quartic cage couplings. These are for the transverse mass of the W boson per production on the left and the W set bosons on the right hand side. Okay, so now moving to the polarization in electroweak, same sign W boson per production in association with jets. Here, deviations in the PBS production of longitudinally polarized gauge bosons have been predicted in different BSM models. And this is the first measurement of the production cross section for polarized same sign W boson pairs. Here, two different VETs have been developed to separate the different polarized final states. The W can be polarized longitudinally and transversely. But here the data set is still quite limited. And in this analysis, the electroweak same sign W boson per production with at least one longitudinally polarized W boson has been measured with a 2.3 sigma significance. We can see here the comparison of the event yields from data and the predicted yields from the different processes for different polarizations. Here, kinematic distributions, depending on if the W boson is longitudinally or transverse polarized, are different. For instance, the W boson for longitudinally polarized W bosons, the PT distribution is softer. Okay, now moving to the observation of the electroweak production of the set boson pairs in association with jets. We can see here the typical diagrams of this process for the electroweak BPS diagrams on the top and for the QCD production on the bottom. Here, this analysis has been performed by both ATLAS and CMS experiments, and this has been performed exploiting the leptonic decays. In the case of ATLAS, the 4 lepton and 2 lepton channels have been used, while CMS has explored only the 4 lepton channel. With this analysis, all the diboson plus 2 jet channels have been observed now. With ATLAS, we achieved an observation of 5.5 sigma, while CMS has evidence of this process with 4 sigma. We can see on the bottom the multivariate discriminant that has been used in ATLAS for the 4 lepton channel on the left and the 2 lepton channel in the middle, where the data are compared to the predicted yields. And in CMS, for the 4 lepton channel, we see the matrix element discriminant that has been used. Now, moving to another process that has been also observed, the electroweak production of W photon plus two jets. Here, the BBS processes comprise an independent and complementary method to study electroweak symmetry breaking. We see here the different Feynman diagrams corresponding to the BBS contribution, the electroweak contribution with triple gauge couplings, with quartic gauge couplings, and on the right hand side, the QCD production. And on the plot, we can see the results and even observed events from data compared to the predicted yields from the different processes. Here we have observed a significance of 4.9 sigma, almost observation, but just to remark that when this is combined with ATV data, an observation of 5.3 sigma has been obtained. And I just presented the W photon plus two jets. Now moving to the set photon plus two jets, we have evidence in this case. This has been obtained with the early RAM2 data set from 2015 plus 2016 with a total integrated luminosity of 36 inverse pentobar. And with this 3.9 sigma significance has been achieved. That is very close to observation to with 4.7 sigma if this is combined with ATV data. Here the signal is extracted using a two-dimensional feed of the diejet invariant mass and diejet pseudorapidity separation.
I'm very sorry, Ruiz Martinez. 5 minutes are left.
Okay, thanks. Uh-huh. I'm finishing. And then the fiducial cross-section is measured and is in agreement with the standard model expectation. Also, constraints on the anomalous quartic gauge couplings have been obtained. We can see in the plots on the bottom the even yields from the data and the predicted yields for the diejet invariant mass and in beams of the diejet pseudorapidity separation. This is for the electron channel set going to electrons on the right hand side and the muon channel on the in the middle. And then we can see in the right hand side the invariant mass of the set and photon system with the data, the events coming from data and the predicted yields. Okay, and now moving to the observation of the production of three massive gauge bosons. This is the first observation of the combined production of three massive gauge bosons for triboson for W and Z. We have performed searches for the individual processes in final states with 3, 4, 5, and 6 leptons, considering only electrons or muons. We can see in the plot on the right hand side the signal strength, which is defined as the measured cross section times branching ratio over the standard model expectation. Here, the results from using BDT or sequential cuts are compared. And on the bottom, we can see the observed events from data and the predicted yields in the case of the same sign dielectron final state, and then 3, 4, 5, and 6 leptons. We have observed a significance of the combined triboson production of 5.7 sigma with this analysis using the full RAM2 dataset. Okay, and this is the last analysis, the inclusive four lepton differential cross section. Here, the four, as you know, the four lepton final state has contributions from many interesting standard model processes, such as the single set boson production and the Higgs boson production or on-shell diboson set production. We can see here the different diagrams that are contributing to this four lepton final state, and this is sensitive to new physics or VSM contributions, like the modifications to the couplings of the Higgs or gauge bosons or possible for fermion interactions. I would like to show you here on the in the plot on the left-hand side the comparison between data and the predicted yields from the different processes. We can see also in the ratio that there is a reasonable agreement. And in on the right-hand side, the differential cross-section as a function of the invariant mass, the four lepton invariant mass, where the measured data are compared to the predictions from Pauhek and Sherpa. And we can see on the in the x-axis the where each process is the dominant one. Okay, so this brings me to my conclusions. We have many new results with the latest and greatest RAN2 data set by the ATLAS and CMS experiments, and the legacy RAN2 measurements are being finalized. We have performed comprehensive tests of the standard model over 15 orders of magnitude in cross-section. We are going now with a large data set, more differential, and the results are being compared to the most accurate theoretical predictions, state-of-the-art Monte Carlo generators, and fixed order calculations. I have presented a test of the lepton flavor universality, which is in very good agreement with the standard model expectation and has the best precision achieved up to now. The first LHC search of the rare exclusive hadronic decay, W going to a pion and a photon, and also first measurements of the production cross sections of polarized same sign W boson pairs. And also we have first evidence of observation of rare processes such as photon-induced processes, or yeah, we have observed now all the diboson plus two jet channels. And we have also observation of triboson. You can find more information in the public material in these links. Thank you very much.
Thank you. There is one question in chat. So let me just read this question. What is the reason for getting two different values for the observed and expected significances?
Yeah, well, this is normal as for the for the expected, this is obtained use with the the expected is with the predictions that we have, and then once this is unblinded that is observed, there are always can be some fluctuations and uncertainties. So